We're now in line with our correspondents in Bamako to for updates of the situation in the Malian capital.
Alou Diawara. Dans la capitale malienne. Alou Diawara, bonjour.
Hello.
Bonjour.
Alors, en réaction à la répression,
in reaction to the repression of the protests on Saturday by the police, the opposition held a press conference yesterday. Can you give us an update on the press release?
Pouvez-vous nous faire le point de cette sortie médiatique de l'opposition?
The organizers unanimously condemned what happened on Saturday. They denounced police violence and called for the resignation of the prime minister who had given the order. The 15 injured during the protests, some of whom were in the press conference, had indicated that they would file a complaint. However, it should be noted that none of the injured spent the night in the hospital.
Toutefois, il faut préciser
the organizers who also met in the coalition have planned to march again on next Friday on the same route as the march was prevented on Saturday. It should be recalled that the protesters are demanding for a credible and transparent election to be held next July. According to them, they are
entendez par cette marche
d'élections
crédibles et transparentes en juillet prochain. Pour eux, il y a les germes de la fraude.
The protesters also demanded equal access to the state media.
Les marcheurs demandaient aussi.
But after Tuesday's events, they added police violence to their struggle.
Après les événements de mardi, ils ont ajouté la violence policière à leur lutte.
The government and the UN Secretary General also issued a statement about this incident on Saturday. What are they saying?
Que dit ce communiqué?
Le Premier ministre dit
the Prime Minister says he learned that security services fired real bullets at the demonstrators on Saturday, 2nd of June. He has formally and vigorously denied this false and slanderous assertion and that has no other purpose than to distract the people. He added that no gunshot wounds have been recorded.
But que de distraire le peuple, fin de citation. Il a ajouté qu'aucun blessé par balle n'a été enregistré.
At the same time, the government claims that the demonstration was banned, given that the state of emergency in the country. He said that in addition to the demonstrators, three police officers were also injured. The UN Secretary General said he had closely followed the evolution of the situation in Mali. These are Saturday's events. He deplored the government's ban on the opposition party demonstrations. He also called on the Malian government to ensure the protection of the fundamental human rights and freedom of expression and to demonstrate peacefully, including within the framework of the current state of emergency.
Il a également appelé le gouvernement malien à assurer la protection des droits de l'homme fondamentaux et la liberté d'expression et de manifester pacifiquement, y compris dans le cadre de l'état d'urgence actuellement en vigueur. Fin de citation.
To wind up, Alou, tension is rising between political parties 2 months before the presidential election. Should we worry about it?
Le pouvoir et l'opposition, à votre avis?
This is what many observers fear here. The situation was tightened very quickly and tension could rise a notch with the prospects of the next Friday march. The first clash between the government and the opposition could even affect the election campaign that starts in early July and promises to be explosive. We feared a post-election crisis and we had a pre-election crisis. But for others, nothing is lost. They just can put the ball down and come.
On a eu une crise préélectorale, mais pour d'autres, rien n'est perdu. Les acteurs peuvent mettre la balle à terre et apaiser l'atmosphère.
For that, we need a dialogue in which each one will give a little of what it has.
Dans lequel chacun va donner un peu du sien.